Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics. In the next few minutes, I'm going to walk you through the work that we've been doing to deliver secure and enterprise-grade productivity experiences from anywhere. We are in an unprecedented time for workplace mobility, and ensuring that everyone can safely access the tools and resources that they need to be productive is more important than ever, whether you're working from home or in the office. IT is at the forefront of enabling these experiences, and it's been humbling to hear many of you talk about the work that you've done to satisfy the increased demand on mobility over these past few weeks. Microsoft Teams is our secure hub for teamwork and integrated online meetings, group chat, file sharing, and more. It lets you stay productive while working remotely. In March, to help with the impact of COVID-19, we announced that Office 365 E1, which includes Microsoft Teams, can be used for 6 months free of charge. More and more of you now use Teams as your collaborative foundation. We have seen unprecedented growth in Teams active usage over the world over the past few weeks, as more of us have had to work from home. And if you haven't started your Teams deployment yet, or need more help, we've published extensive guidance for getting Teams deployed at scale that you can check out at aka.ms/Microsoft Teams for IT. Now, of course, enabling your users to work from anywhere, regardless of the industry you're in, requires a level of confidence and control over how your users access information across different endpoints and different networks. To ease the burden for you and IT, today I'm excited to announce a number of new capabilities. These new capabilities include a unified access control plane for device and access management with Microsoft Endpoint Manager and Azure Active Directory to help ensure all endpoints connecting to corporate resources are safe. A new management experience for Windows Virtual Desktop to quickly provision and manage remote desktops and applications, as well as the ability to get insights you need to know to measure how your organization is working and the quality of the experience you're delivering to your users through the Microsoft Productivity Score. Now let's start with Microsoft Endpoint Manager. We've done a lot of work to ensure that you can enable your users to use their device of choice while ensuring secure and tailored access to your corporate information and services. Strong authentication is critical as more and more people log in from different networks on different devices. We've now made multi-factor authentication a security default for all new Microsoft 365 tenants. Enabling MFA decreases the likelihood of being compromised by more than 99.9%, and this is now enabled by default. For broader endpoint management across your apps and devices, we've improved the integration between Configuration Manager and the Microsoft Endpoint Manager Admin Center in the Microsoft 365 console. You can try the new Endpoint Manager portal yourself at endpoint.microsoft.com. Now let me update you on a few more highlights. First, what we call tenant attach. Starting with the 2002 release of Configuration Manager, you can now attach an Intune tenant to your Configuration Manager deployment. And what that does is it automatically uploads all of your Configuration Manager devices up into the Intune service and allows you to take actions like policy, devicing directly from that single administrative console called the Microsoft Endpoint Manager Admin Center. This will help speed up common actions you might take across all your devices. And your help desk will now be able to see all the devices managed by Microsoft Endpoint Manager in one single web-based experience. We've also worked to bring the richness of Software Center from Configuration Manager and My Apps from Azure Active Directory into the Intune company portal for a unified app delivery so all people can get all the apps they need across all their endpoints. Now, don't worry if you're using Software Center or My Apps as standalone portals. They're not going away and we'll continue to invest in them. A few months back, we also released the new Microsoft Edge browser. We think about Edge in the same way we think about the security of our Office apps. So we've built all of that manageability and security that we built into Office 365 also into Microsoft Edge. Now, Edge gives you unmatched security capabilities, along with personal privacy, and the highest level of compatibility for both your modern web and your existing app investments. Edge is now the Microsoft 365 managed browser across all your device platforms. Our endpoint management experiences natively integrate the app and package deployment process for Edge on the PC, on macOS, and the managed mobile Edge for iOS and Android directly from the Apple App Store or Google Play. We also have a security baseline now dedicated to Edge. As Microsoft Endpoint Manager is a unified platform for all your endpoints, I'm really excited to talk about what the team has built specifically for macOS management. We're introducing the Intune MDM agent for macOS, which goes beyond the native built-in management controls of macOS. For example, with shell scripting, admins can now leverage the agent to automate all their repetitive tasks. And this is just the beginning of the new capabilities that we're bringing. We are well on our way of giving admins a first-class macOS management experience in Microsoft Endpoint Manager. Now, our partnership with Jamf continues, and you can continue to use the incredible breadth and depth of management and access controls from Jamf in connection with Microsoft Endpoint Manager. Next, let's talk about Endpoint Virtualization. Over the past few months, we've seen unprecedented growth in the use of Windows Virtual Desktop as more and more people are working from home. Windows Virtual Desktop is our complete desktop and app virtualization service running on Azure. As a part of Azure's global footprint and network, you can provision virtual Windows sessions anywhere in the world. Since the initial release in September, we've made some significant updates. First, we've expanded the service instances to additional geographies, including Europe, Asia, Australia, and South America, in addition to the coverage we already had in North America. Second, we've released the new updated Windows Virtual Desktop Admin Center, which dramatically simplifies getting WVD running for your users. Now, third, for managing user experience in VM automation, we've improved our auto-scaling. Now it's integrated with Azure Automation and Logic Apps with pre-built templates to help you spin up and drain your virtual machines with robust automation. Now, additionally, we've improved the remote meeting and collaboration experience when using Microsoft Teams from WVD-hosted machines with AV redirection for video calling. This creates a direct path between your endpoints when sharing video, helping increase video and audio quality while reducing latency. Now, finally, let's talk about our focus on helping you deliver the best experience possible for your end users. More than at any time in the past, the experience that you deliver for your users has a direct impact on employee sentiment and culture. This is why we're introducing the Microsoft Productivity Score. Productivity Score will take what we learn at our cloud scale and give you specific and actionable insights and recommendations of your current user experience and the best next action to improve it. We'll also show you which teams and which users in your organizations are working in modern ways and how well you're doing in comparison to other organizations. And beyond providing just tenant-level information, we're now going to be able to give you specific user-level insights in areas such as content collaboration, so you can understand which people are reading, authoring, co-authoring, and collaborating on content through OneDrive and SharePoint. Here under mobility, you can see how users are able to work from any device by using the web and mobile apps in addition to the desktop versions of the Office apps. Then in communication, we help you understand how people communicate via email, chat, or Yammer posts, but you get to see that holistic view of what they're using. We're also adding information around how your endpoint experience and network contribute to the end user experience and productivity. Here in the connectivity area, we're going to help you understand which office locations have performance challenges in connecting and using Office 365. In endpoint analytics, we're going to help you understand one of my favorite things, what we call time to productivity. For example, your PC should boot quickly. I use cold boot as the example here because it is one of these things that every user experiences. I've shown you before that my personal PC, I can actually boot this in under 15 seconds, and that's with all of the security controls that Microsoft puts on my corporate device. Now, to learn more about what's new about Productivity Score, check out aka.ms/productivityscoreblog. So that was a quick tour of the work that we've been doing to help you bring more mobile and collaborative experiences to your users, while ensuring your information is protected in a time when many of us are working remotely. To go even deeper on these topics and more, check out aka.ms/APrilITnews and keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech news from Microsoft. Thanks for watching.